In this video, we'll be taking a look at signal input configuration for the PM-50A analog panel meter. The PM-50A is capable of accepting signals in the form of voltage, current, resistance, RTD, or thermocouple. For this demonstration, I'll be configuring my PM-50 to accept a 4 to 20 milliamp signal, which I'll be scaling from 0 to 100. I'll be using the PM-50 web server for this, but the menu structure will be the same whether you're using the web server or the touchscreen of your PM-50 unit. Here's a quick look at how the 4 to 20 milliamp signal is wired to the PM-50. One thing to note is that the terminals being used for signal input will change depending on the type of signal being used. You can find the wiring diagrams for all signal types in the PM-50A user manual. I've already logged into my PM-50 using the admin credentials, so now I'll navigate to the device menu to get started. From here, click once on Signal Input Configuration. Next, click once on the Signal Input Configuration menu item to expand it. The first thing that we see here is Input Type, and since I'm using a 4 to 20 milliamp signal, I'll be selecting Current here. For current range, I'll be selecting plus minus 20 milliamps to account for the full range of my analog signal. Input sample rate is the number of times per second that the input is measured. I'll be leaving this at 10 samples per second, which will be plenty fast for this demonstration. Display update rate is the number of times the measured value is updated on the physical display per second. This won't affect the update rate of our web browser, so I'll leave this at 2 times per second. Display unit's decimal point is where we can change the decimal position of the measured value. I'll be changing this to 0 because we just want to display 0 to 100 with no decimal point. Rounding value allows us to round the input reading to the nearest value selected here. I'll leave this at 1 so that no rounding occurs for this demonstration. In the offset display field, we can enter an offset value which would be added to the absolute value to create the relative value. I'll be leaving this at 0 as no offset will be needed here. Next, we have the digital filter which is designed to steady the input display reading. A value of 0 disables filtering, which I'll be doing for this demonstration. Here we have filter band. When input signal variation exceeds the input filter band value, the digital filter disengages. I'll change this to 0 since we're not using a digital filter. Next up, we have scaling points A, which is the number of scaling points for list A. Our 4 to 20 milliamp signal will be linearly scaled from 0 to 100, so 2 scaling points is enough. If needed, we could have up to 10 scaling points for a nonlinear scale. For scaling type A, this will be left at enter values, which is the only option from the web server. Note that from the unit itself, you'll have the option to apply signal rather than enter the values. Scaling point A1 will be the low end of our input signal, which is 4 milliamps. I'll enter a value of 4 here to represent that. Display point A1 will be 0 in this case, because 4 milliamps will represent a value of 0. Scaling point A2 will be the high end of our input signal, which is 20 milliamps. I'll enter a value of 20 here to represent that. Display point A2 will be 100 in this case, because 20 milliamps will represent a value of 100. Next up, we have enable scale list B. At this point, we could configure separate scaling points for list B by clicking the slider to enable. I'll do that now to give you a quick look, but we won't be using scale list B in this demonstration. As you can see, once that's enabled, we have a new set of scaling points available for list B. I'll go ahead and disable that now. Finally, we have a slider to show min-max capture parameter. Enabling this gives us options for min and max capture assignment and duration. I'll give you a quick look at that as well, and we'll leave these at their default values. At this point, we can test our newly configured 4 to 20 milliamp signal input. I'll click Save and then we can navigate back home so that we can watch our signal in real time. My signal generator is currently set to 4 milliamps, which is displaying 0 as expected. Now I'll begin to increase the signal to 12 milliamps, and you'll see that we approach a value of 50, as this is 50% of our analog scale. As you can see, 12 milliamps gave us a value of 50, as expected. Now I'll start to increase the signal to 20 milliamps so that we can see it reach its full value of 100. And as you can see, 20 milliamps gave us a value of 100 as expected. And that's it for PM-50A signal input configuration. Thank you for watching.